doctor, and there was a guy that he went through college 7 years, Brother Gary, 7 years. And I said, Martin, I said, what is Kevin taking? He goes, nothing. And I'm like, what do you mean nothing? He goes, yeah. His mom and dad are gazillionaires. They live in California. And they said, as long as he stays in Ann Arbor, he can do whatever he wants. So he never took one class, Brother Joe.
Can you imagine that? Like,
oh my goodness. What a way to live. You want to take up the offering? Okay. Well, tell everybody to say, stand up. Everybody stand. Brother Arlie Creech used to say, get your wallet quicker that way. Now, are you going to give thanks for the offering? Do you want Big G Daddy to do it? You? How, him? Well, point to him and say, G, go ahead, tell him. Right there, he's right there.
Over there.
Over there, tell him. Say, go ahead, Big G. Okay. She's so shy. All right, come on, Brother Gary.
I have been scared of kindness and laughter because I've been really
a good thing. All right. Go ahead, Brother Gary.
Most kind of heavenly gracious Father God, Lord, as we pick up this offering this morning, Lord, we ask you, Father God, Lord, to bless it, Lord, that in a world full of sin, Father God, Lord, this little body be able to preach and teach Jesus Christ to the lost, Father. Lord, help us and guide us to be good stewards of it, Lord. Bless those who got to give and those who don't. Lord, bless it from our heart. For it be in Christ Jesus' name we ask. Amen.
Okay, come on. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more, and the morning grace be turned bright and fair, when the saints shall gather over on the altar shore, and the roll is called down to God be fair, when the roll is called up
mighty that never seen. You that answered the phone, I am so blessed today.
Amen. 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 And you, amen, that look down on people. Amen. And they did look down on that woman. Amen. Honey, listen. Amen. Amen. What did people think of me and you?
Amen.
When we was out into the world. Amen. Honey, listen. They said, nothing but come healthy to drop. Amen. Amen. Let me tell you something. Only God can change you in the twinkling of an eye. Amen. From what you was. Amen. 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 To the child of God. Amen. God is good. Amen. That song just sang. And God is good. Amen. I don't see how people can get up and go out. Let me tell you something. Honey, you can see God anywhere if you want to see Him. Amen. He's in the basement sometimes. Amen. Amen. Anywhere you call up on God, God will be there.
Amen.
That's what He said.
Amen.
There goes that woman down there. They didn't, I don't think they brought her down there, sat her in a chair, and said, Jesus, you made a mistake. No, they didn't do that. I believe they drug her in her half
throats.
Threw her on the ground. Now, Jesus, what are you going to do with this one? The law of Moses said, amen, that we can stone her to death. She's no good. Amen. Listen. Amen. Amen. What should we think of God? Thought of us when we were down in the world. We weren't better than her. No, we weren't. Amen. Amen. You know, we look down sometime before we catch ourselves and look down on somebody. I know. One day, amen. Now at the Kroger's, I don't do a lot of grocery shopping. Amen. I make 10 phone calls to find out where the stuff is. Amen. And listen. Amen. Amen. A woman bumped me in her 30s out there and said, can you help me? I got a 13-year-old daughter and we're hungry. I give her some money. Yeah, I come by and said, I wouldn't do that. I said, that's why I done it. Because you wouldn't do it. Amen. Hey, listen. I don't know what she was going to do with it. I cleared my heart. Amen. I cleared my heart. Was she going to get drunk on it? Whatever. I'm not reliable for that. God, I believe it said, if I'm wrong, you can just correct me. Be careful how you treat people.
Yeah,
so many ways. And I'll be an angel or this right. Or something like that. Amen. That one that we look down upon sometime. Amen. Amen. Maybe God said.
Yeah.
Amen. Might be one of God's people. Amen. So we got to be careful in life. It ain't about adultery. Them boys wanted to catch Jesus.
Yeah.
If the truth was known, they had been with her too.
Yeah.
Amen.
If the truth was known. If I remember right, they were in the temple. When they brought her in there, half naked, and threw her down on the ground. Jesus looked up. This is very important. You know what it says. Don't you listen for a minute. When he slowly, I believe, looked up, said, you that's so good. Amen. You cast that stone on her. First
stone.
You be the first one to condemn this woman as a stone. I believe you hear stone drop.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Amen.
Amen. I really do. And another stone. And another stone. Amen. I believe there was a lot of people going out the back door of that temple. Because he didn't just condemn them, I believe he condemned a lot of people.
Oh, yeah.
How many men in there, you never know, had been with this woman, and now they all want to come and crucify her. Amen. Stone her to death. Amen. Because of the sin. In other words, honey, listen, this ain't about adultery. It's about forgiveness.
Yeah, yes, it is. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Without forgiveness, preacher, where would we be?
Amen.
We'd be in a bad spot, wouldn't we?
We'd be lost.
That's right.
Amen. 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 I tell you what, amen. There's nothing more pleasure in this life that I've ever tried, amen, to get up and feel the feeling of God, amen. When you get up and you're thankful for a cup of coffee, amen. And listen, amen. Pray about everything, amen. And when prayers are answered, give Him praise for it. And then when He gives you the praise for it, come to church and worship Him.
Amen. Hallelujah. Lord bless
you. Amen. I wanted to hear Joey this morning. But you know what? One Sunday, he got up and started preaching. Didn't ask me. Didn't have to ask me. Yeah. If God's in it, go for it.
Let it go. Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. I'm glad that somebody's comfortable enough. Amen. Well, no, Jordan, well, we got three songs. We got to do this, 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 and then you can get up. Obey God when God is calling.
Yeah, that's right. The Spirit moves into Florida.
Which schedule got out of churches anymore? You know, we really have. Amen. Talked to a guy pretty well in the Bible. Now, one time, trick question, I wouldn't answer. So, what do you think about somebody been married twice? Can you preach? Here was the answer. It's not the way Baptists believe. I want something about it. You can't prove to me that that's in the Bible. When Jesus called the deacons and them, he said, you must be the husband of one wife. He didn't say you can never be divorced, did he?
That's right.
But I'm going to tell you this, it depends on a lot of things.
Yes.
I had a friend that married the deacon's wife. Then the deacon's daughter married the pastor's son, and I wouldn't want to be around it. That would be you when they had. Every individual is different.
Yes. Yeah. That's true. Amen.
An old friend of mine, his daughter got married when she was going this valley. He said, you ain't going down there to that church where he goes. They're bad people. They wash people's feet. You ain't going down there. They end up alone. He got on drugs bad. They had old twins. She came down there one day. He was in the drugs. Drug dealers don't care how many kids you got. Nope. You don't pay them, they'll kill you whole family.
Yes, they will.
She came down there and told the dad something about divorce. He said, no, you're not. You made that bed, you're going to stay in it. And I said, Stan, you got two old grandbabies up there. Drug dealers don't care. I don't care. You retired. Church, that's wrong.
Amen, brother.
That is wrong. Amen. I don't know why God is. I'm tired of seeing people that's been married before for a good reason be put down as second grade Christians. Second grade Christians.
Amen.
Amen. You take a preacher you don't know that's been married before, come up here and somebody gets saved. They shout and raise their hands. Even if they find out he'd been married before, that don't count. I've seen it happen.
Amen. Come on.
There was a church here, wouldn't let Judah's sister even use the church to get married. Baptist way. What about the Bible way?
Yeah.
Amen. 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 I don't want to hear about old hard shell Baptist. I've been around my whole life. Now, I'm going to tell you this, huh? The word must keep being preached. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Amen?
Amen.
The word's got to be preached.
Amen. Amen. Lord bless you.
Prove to me in the Bible where it says you can only be married one time. If anybody can show me that, I'll apologize.
It don't say it, brother.
That's right. Amen? But they'll tell you this is the Baptist way, or this is the Holiest way, this is Pentecost way, because we're up here higher. We're higher than what you are. You lower people. And let me tell you something. Amen. I believe if God has come, it says in the Bible, amen. If one wants to go, let him go. You're free.
Yep.
If God has freed you, don't listen to nobody else. You're free.
Yeah.
Amen.
Let him go in peace.
I wanted a Bible answer.
Yeah.
Baptists don't believe the Bible. That's what you got. That's the way that we put a religion in front of the Bible. We can't. Amen. We can't. I don't know how I got on that.
Tell me it didn't cost nothing extra.
Amen. It's free. Did that get out of that big paycheck that's paid? Zero, 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 like the law in school. Word, and my point of all that is, amen. The word has to be preached.
Amen.
The word has to be kept going. Amen. Be preached.
Amen.
And it's going to get rougher and rougher.
Yes, it is.
Church, I'm telling you, it is. Just look at the saints in here. There was probably a time to fall. I remember a time in Kentucky, Parsonsburg, get there early, you can't even get something. What's happened? God got smaller?
No.
I blame him. He's so big you can't get over. He's so wide you can't get around. He's so low you can't crawl under. You're going to have to come through the door.
Yeah.
Amen. If you don't, you're a liar and a thief, I believe. See, I don't say it's a thief. I'm a liar. I'm a liar and a thief.
Deep in
a robber and a thief. Amen. Listen, you know it's like that. That preacher come up here and preached that revival and said, all religions are good.
Yeah.
Until you die.
Yeah.
Then the great separation is coming.
Yeah.
Amen. So if you're here today, amen, and you've been saved, amen, think about this. Of all the millions of people in this world, how did he find a snotty old kid from Boomer Hall? I know he don't need a road map, he knows where mine is. He ain't even a road map here. Why did he choose me? I wasn't no good. I didn't have no big scholarship thing on my wall. Don't get me wrong, education is good. I wish I had more of it. I wasn't smart enough to do it. Amen. Well, I was a priest. Yeah, go stand with your parishioners have been before God. If you didn't preach, these people are going to hell. Unless they're saved, you're going with them.
Yep.
Amen.
That's the simple part of it. Yeah. It's simple as even a child can understand that.
Exactly right.
Amen. You must be born again.
Yep.
He made it plain to Nicodemus, I believe it was.
Yes, yeah. He did.
Amen. He said, well, Nicodemus said, well, Jesus, that is impossible. Impossible for me to enter into my mother's womb. I'm a grown man and be reborn. Amen. 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 Jesus talking about accepting him.
Yep. Amen.
To be reborn. You know, a lot of people have said this and I've seen it. Amen. Now, I ain't getting on nobody here. I'm just preaching. Amen. A lot of people have been to Calvary. A lot of people. And they think they got a bargain in the chip. Now, Lord, listen, I can give up so much, but you know, we got a party Saturday and Sunday night. Mm-hmm. I can't give that up. And they turn away and they go to hell.
Amen.
Amen.
They never been to Pentecost. I've seen many of them come up here to an altar in the churches I pastor, young people. Amen. I seen parents, and here's the worst part, come up and dedicate their child.
Yep.
And they don't even come to church. Mm-hmm. You can't dedicate something you can't dedicate.
That's right.
Amen.
You can't do it. Yeah. But look at them parents. The fruit she went to the bar, and not that little girl's going to know that.
Amen.
She's going to remember that.
Yeah. Amen.
And she brings you to church all the time.
She'll remember that too.
Church.
Yep.
And they're paying more attention than you think they are.
Yeah. Yes, they are.
They sure they are.
Yep.
They might have heard of that.
Got lost.
Worship, prayer, praise, and worship is three different things. It's an element of it. But honey, you come to worship, you ain't asking for nothing. You ain't saying, thank you, Lord, for that's praise. That's praising Him for what He's done for us, Gary. And not only what He's done for us, that we know things that He's done and we don't have no idea have been done.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We come to worship. Down on our knees and humble ourselves as a child and just say, Lord, I just won't sit with you. You know, they told Job, you must have done something bad.
Yeah.
If I remember the story, right?
Yeah.
Hey, man, he's sitting there losing everything. Bowls, if I remember right, all over his body, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
You must have done something real bad. It gets to me when people get real sick and people come and say, you must have sinned bad, or God wouldn't have brought this on you. That is wrong.
Amen.
Outright wrong.
Yes.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
I tell you, you better take care of your life. Don't worry about mine. If I'm on my deathbed, I'm all right because I've been saved.
Amen.
You go worry about yours. Amen.
That's true.
Get your life in order before you come and preach to me. Amen. Joe hasn't done nothing wrong that I can remember reading. Not one thing wrong. Even his wife, if I remember right, came and said, Job, curse God and die.
Yeah.
He said, if I remember right, did he say, you foolish woman, or something like that?
Yeah.
He hadn't done nothing wrong. God was showing the devil, you ain't getting this one.
Yeah.
You can take everything he's got. You know the way this government's going, we may lose everything in the next year, year and a half.
Yeah.
Amen. They can physically come in now and take everything you've got.
Amen.
And ain't a thing you can do about it.
That's right.
Nothing. It's the truth. They got more guns and they got more people. It's only God will make a change in this country.
Amen.
Amen. Lord.
And I tell you what, if everybody in this country, every proclaimed Christian, last I heard 298 million people in this country proclaimed to be Christians. I say, we're the men and women of God.
Yeah, yeah,
amen. Yeah. You can walk in that door and claim I'm a Christian. That don't mean nothing to me.
Yeah.
All you got to do is look on the tree. If it's dead, it's dead.
Yeah.
Bless the Lord.
Yeah, I forgot where I'm at again. God bless you. Where was that, Gary?
Everywhere.
Huh?
Everywhere.
Everywhere. I live.
Where you need to be.
A lot of people get prayer, worship. Prayer, praise, and worship mixed up. Worship, we just come to sit with God for a while. What a great God you are. Don't need nothing today. Everything's good. See, when we pray, we're asking for something. Amen. That's good. And we see Him answer prayers. We're in church testifying. You know what God has done for us? But when do we worship God? Praised Him for what He's done. We just come and say, man, God, what a generous God you got. You are.
Yeah.
Amen. You've walked with me these many years. I don't want nothing today. I'm good to go. Because I've got you.
Amen.
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 I've got you.
That's the Lord.
I'm telling you, church, you know, and I'm not getting on nobody, but and I'm not saying because I'm a pastor, church I should be full.
Should.
People have lost in their hearts, children. The
salvation that he gave me. Amen. They used to bring the prisoners up at the courthouse and they said, every one of them finds God in jail.
In the face of
until they get out on the street and they lose it again.
Yeah.
Anybody can say they're a Christian. But you know, we're out that door. That's when we got to prove it.
Yep.
Amen.
If you do somebody wrong in a building, they're going to know it.
That's right.
Amen.
Tanya does nails and that up here, and one of the girls has got a sign over there. It says, I'd rather be a sinner than a lying hypocrite.
Amen.
Somebody hurt that girl bad.
Mm-hmm. That's the truth.
Somebody done that girl bad, and she'll never forget that. Amen. Now, somebody steals from me, they're not going to be balancing my checkbook.
Right.
If they're all the time putting me down, I sit on the side of the flat, I'll stop and help them. But I'm not going to be breaking bread with them that evening.
Well, that's the Lord's hand.
Amen.
Yeah.
And Lord bless you.
Oh.
It's about forgiveness. And here's the important part. People have done me wrong, and I hate to say it, but it's been Christians more than the world.
Amen.
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 Jesse Shackelford, Richie remembers. We ordained, what's his name up there now?
Gary.
A few years later, we found out it was a mess, what he'd done, blah, 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 blah. Jesse wanted his name off in papers. He called me more than once. I said, Jesse, you're not a follower of me, how that man did. Nobody knew this. He actually put him in the nut house for a couple of weeks. And I said, Jesse, you're free from that. The man stood here and said this, 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 and this, and you were vicious. And he was lying. It's not on you, it's on him.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
Lord, I know we still fight your name. But so long, Reed, you never asked me to come back. A lot of preachers, a lot of churches you visit, they won't ask you to preach. I'm just telling the truth. They're afraid you preach better than them, who they listen to. We preached a revival over here at Evergreen Acres back a few years. Reese was there. 12, 13 days. And he said, how long are you going to preach? I said, as long as there's one coming to that altar, get saved or rededicated, we're going to keep preaching.
Amen.
And 13 days. I was about it. See, too many times, and I know sometimes they're limited to work and this and that. When you come to preach your Bible, follow God. Because if God said, hey, you need to go another week on that, buddy, you've got to work it out with your work.
Amen.
I believe that.
Yeah.
We've got to put God first in everything we do.
Amen.
You know, a guy wants to, by the way, if he went and bought a chest or a table, he asked God to bless it. I just think that's so silly. There ain't nothing silly about it. Mm-hmm. You ask God to bless everything in your life.
Yep. Amen.
Amen.
Yep. Amen.
We need to get back to the old ways.
Yeah. Yeah.
We do.
Amen.
The real old ways. 50 years ago, most of these people in the big churches would have been kicked out from what they were.
Yep.
And what they believe.
Yep.
Amen.
That's true.
But somehow the devil's got in there. Now, I'm not saying all of it's like it. Amen. And one of the preachers, he said he was asked to go preach in the Catholic Church, and he wouldn't. I said, boy, you missed an opportunity. You'll send robes coming off when the Spirit started working. And people down on their knees praying to God. Amen. Amen. They have their own Bibles. They don't go for this Bible that we go by. Amen. They worship
Mary, amen. Mary didn't save me. Joseph didn't save me. Isaac didn't. Abraham, none of them saved me. But Jesus Christ himself.
Amen.
If you worship anything else, amen, you're going to hell. Plain and simple.
Amen. That's the truth.
And nobody's ever argued that way. If you're not saved, you're going to hell. I believe all Baptists, Pentecost, all of them believe that we can agree on that. Amen.
Amen.
A lot of territory in between that we may not believe. Yet, had a preacher leave the church one time. He, I don't know, somebody mentioned something about pre-millennial on post, and he got up and left. I said, listen, buddy, it's about getting people saved.
Yeah.
We'll worry about that when the time comes.
Amen.
If we're saved,
Amen.
God's going to take care of us, whether it's here, there, or wherever it is.
That's right.
Jesus said, amen, that we will be with him.
Amen.
Amen. All that matters.
Amen. You know, people has left the church over any disagreement. I was in the bar. You can see people fist fight on Friday night. Beat the heck out of each other. Saturday night, they're back in the bar buying each other a beer.
Yeah.
And you can't get a Christian to apologize or nothing. Let me tell you something today, church, and we're about done. I ain't gonna lie too much today. I won't enjoy the preaching. I'm glad that we're all free to obey God when they feel it's here and there.
It's the truth.
That message won't go bad until we act. That's till suffering's come up to where I'm burning out to where it was. And I end up preaching. And I said, I apologize to him. He said, buddy, don't you worry. I ain't had a message to go bad on me my whole life. He was good.
Yes, he was.
But be a Christian. No matter how bad somebody does you, you've got to forgive them.
Amen.
I don't mean you have to, like I said, break bread with them.
Amen.
But you have to forgive them. Even if they never, and most of them never will. They're right. It ain't going to change. They're not going to apologize for nothing. But to free you, with Jesus, what's bound up in heaven will be bound on earth, I believe it says. And if you walk around not forgiving somebody, then why should God forgive you?
That's right.
And if you know you've done somebody wrong, you need to go and apologize.
Amen.
It's not about them, it's freeing you. Because if you're bound up with people, there's people who are, you know, I had a brother and sister got over a $5,000 issue and didn't speak for 25 years, she came to his funeral. Why are you coming to his funeral? He's both doing 25 years. And they tried to pull him in and I said, hey, I ain't got no fight. This dog is just fine. That's between you two, because you ain't going to win.
No.
Whoever won the $5,000, this and that, guess what? They're not going to win. Either one of them's not going to win.
No.
It's family. You're not going to win that on either side, and I'm not getting into it, because then I'm going to have both of them mad at me. $5,000, they didn't speak to each other for about 25 years. The devil can use anything and anybody to destroy a family.
Yes, he can.
And he will.
He will, if you let him.
Anyway, if I'm done, Gary's looking over at your dad, you don't like him. Don't even like him. Well, listen, it's about, and I won't catch it in saying, and everybody with the church ain't over. Church ain't over. Come up here and sing. And Reese, whoever wants to sing, this is God's day.
Amen.
That he set aside for him.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you want to worship him? Obey the Lord this morning.
Yeah. Yeah.
If it's 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock when we get out, don't worry about it. Shouldn't plan nothing on Sunday anymore.
Man.
I didn't hear 2 amen. I'm telling you the truth.
need to get back to the old ways.
Yeah.
We need to get back, put God first in our life. We need to get back and bring the children to church. I saw so many teenagers gone the way they've gone because their parents raised them that way.
Yeah.
I'll tell this, then I'll shut up, maybe you're a 16-year-old boy went to this church for 6 months. His dad got mad and went down there to see the pastor. He said, "I don't know why my boy ain't been saved." He said, "I don't know, you tell me he's been with you for 16 years, he's only been here 6 months." Amen?
Amen. Amen.
It's the truth. Parents actually think they're helping these kids.
Yeah.
While letting them do what they want.
That's right.
Hey, the good intentions may have started. Now, we all want our kids to do better than what we have and what we do. Let me tell you something.
Thank you, Lord.
If God ain't the number one thing in that kid's life, he's going wrong.
Yeah.
That's right.
He's going wrong. She's going wrong. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. In other words, Joey, I believe it starts to come.
Amen.
You can't expect her to come to church if you don't.
Right.
That's right.
Amen. If you're out drinking, Daddy does it.
Yeah, I can.
If you've got kids in church like her, we ought to be thankful.
Amen.
And I'm sure you are every day.
Hallelujah.
Amen. We need to get back to the old style. Remember when old women used to run the house? I remember there were two at Union Street. Well, they get happy and they were just running out of the place and shouting. You got them out there. Kathy and Brenda might remember them, but I forget their name, you know. Now, if you can get an amen, you're doing good. Amen. You know, you know how hard it is for a preacher or pastor to stand up here and preach a call? And don't get much support.
It's true.
God don't get rid of pastors. People get rid of pastors.
Amen.
But now, people get tired of pastors, y'all know them on down the road.
Yep.
Amen. God ain't got any small. People can still be healed. By prayer.
Yep.
Amen.
Yep.
God's still on the throne, no matter what we're going through today.
Amen.
Tomorrow and next day, God's still in charge.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now we may think, "God, you can't hear my prayers. What's going on?" I firmly believe He's got something better to make it.
Amen.
Amen. I do. Yeah, you can suffer for a while. Amen. But I do believe when you lose a job or your husband walk out, your wife walk out, it may not be a divorce. It may be a rescue plan. Anyway, because God said it. He set you free. He told him, I can't think of his name, about the food. He said, "I can't eat that." Who was that?
Peter. Calling that down the road?
Yeah. I think Peter, yeah. God said, "Listen, anything I've made clean,
it's clean."
Yeah.
Amen.
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 Don't worry about it. Amen.
Amen.
There are people still there when they part.
What?
People ask, this world has got, I've seen the thing of the day, only 35% of the people go to church anymore. And 98% of people might be a Christian. And if you ask them, "Well, I'm not a participating Christian." Well, if I don't drink, you can't call me a drunk. Why would I say, "Well, I'm not participating at all"? It don't make sense, does it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yep, my name goes here in the big church, preacher. my preacher, pastor, priest, whatever you want to call him, says, I'm good to go. You are good to go to heaven without Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. That's it. I am going to shut up. Gary's counting the light of the total world. But you know that woman that they brought down there? They didn't bring her down there to get forgiveness.
No.
They brought her down there to stone her.
Yes, they did.
And they wanted to choke Jesus. Mm-hmm. The Pharisees and scribes, though they was, I remember that. And I believe they was in shock when he raised his head. You know, people worried about what he wrote on the ground. You've got this high class, for lack of a word, people, that these big preachers and this and that, they have a theory about what he wrote on the ground. That's not what I got out of that. I got forgiveness. For in them days, it was one of the worst things you could do. Amen. You can literally be stoned to death. Yeah. And Jesus looked up. Okay, Mr. High and Mighty, you draw this old person on. You hit her with a person. I believe it was a girl that was condemned in her heart.
Amen.
I really do. And like I said, if there was a back door, I believe it'd be revolved. And the other people sitting in that temple, that he had so much power with just a few words. You, without sin, I believe went through it all the time. That's the first time.
Yeah.
I believe they was ready to do it. The people sat in the temple, I believe they was ready to do it.
Right.
Amen. Amen. I'm going to shut up. Get a song ready. We'll get Kathy in there.
Come on, ladies.
Huh?
I just have to
call. I want to hear my song.
Uh-oh. Kathy?
Hey, no. Hey.
I told you, Steve.
8180, that's the one coming with.
Oh, no, not that one.
But she's going to do it.
While they're getting ready, I'd like to say I want to praise God for what he's done for me. And this morning when you were talking about asking what you could do for him today, and it wasn't something that I did, but I was in the middle of the dollar store of all places, and I had all kinds of stuff on my mind. And a lady that was in front of me, who I didn't know from nobody, turned around and said, "May God bless you and have a wonderful day." Just those little words, and what I got down there was like, God's thinking about me.
Yeah.
Me, this little person of me. All at once, all of everybody else, and he sent me a message, just a little finger. And she obeyed him, and she turned around, and she just don't know what she did for me that day.
Amen. Appreciate that. You don't know what a couple words can do in somebody's life. You know, I'm going to shut up. You're going to shut up. You know, somebody might be a suicide. You know what? Somebody might be able to ready to take their own life.
Yeah.
A couple kind words, Jonah could stop that.
Mm-hmm.
It really could. Go inside, open the rich. It wasn't about adultery. It was about forgiveness. Go ahead, thank you. Obey the Lord.
Now that was already on, and I heard we tested it twice this morning. You got it? Talk to me.
Testing.
It works.
Yeah, it
is. It's working. It's just not coming up.
It's working. Yeah. Well, we're giving Joe 2 more weeks to get some break.
Testing.
Yeah, it is.
Testing.
Oh, I know the song. Let me set up on your
testing.
There's a storm on the horizon, walk me through.
Bless the Lord.
As I fail.
to those who need. I'm not bragging on me, I'm bragging on him.
That's right, man.
Because he first loved me.
Yeah.
And made a way for me.
That's right.
Everything I own belongs to him anyways.
Yeah.
And little do they know, he thinks I'm rich. He thinks I got this big old bank account down there with Fifth Third or wherever it is. Little does he know just about everything I've ever earned. I've handed it out to this family.
Yeah.
Gave to their kids. Put roofs over their heads.
That's right.
I don't have anything else to give them. But Jesus.
Yeah.
I can offer Jesus to them.
That's good.
And I know one thing.
Amen. Lord bless you.
When the storm is raging, he can walk me through.
That's right.
As long as I keep my eyes on him,
that's right.
He can walk us through.
That's right.
That don't mean the storm ain't going to rage around us. Sometimes you think we're going to go under and we're going to drown. But I used to tell people, if I go under, I'm going to go under holding on to his hand.
Yeah.
Because when he gets done, he's going to pull me up out of that water
right.
In his time, in his season.
Yeah.
But you know what? I'm so grateful, Dave, that I don't get what I deserve every day. Even in all that I just said, I still don't deserve what Jesus done for me on Calvary.
That's right. Me
neither.
And where would we be?
Without him.
25, I got to sing this song. She don't understand. I got to do what God has me to do. Sometimes she picks out songs and the Spirit says, no, you need to go this way. But you think she'd know me by now. She's known me over 30 years, and I'm going to do what the Lord says. I don't care if they throw me out there on the street. They threaten to do that too. But he's walked me through, Vanessa. He's faithful.
Amen.
Even when I'm not faithful,
amen.
He's faithful. Never prayed a prayer that he couldn't answer.
That's right.
Never shed a tear that he couldn't dry. I'm so glad I serve one who knows all about me and loves me just the same. But this morning, where would we be if it wasn't for Jesus and Calvary? He could have called 10,000 angels.
Yes, he could. Yeah.
Took him right off that cross.
And this is something I don't understand. He said, for the joy that was set before me.
Yeah. Endured this.
He endured, all that shame and all that went with it. So I believe he looked ahead in time and he saw a little lost girl.
That's right.
And he come by my way and he saved my soul. Didn't understand it then, don't understand it now. But I believe it with everything that's in me.
Amen.
Because the Spirit beareth witness.
That's right.
I can worship with anybody.
That's right.
If they believe in the Lord going to the cross. Dying for my sins, buried and resurrected, I can worship with you. I don't fight with nobody over scriptures. Used to in my younger days, buddy, I tell you what, I'd get in a room and I'd argue that Bible with anybody that wanted to argue with it. But as I got older, I realized that it didn't accomplish nothing. That made me look like a foolish person. So now I just say, are you saved? That's all that matters. You can study it out. However you come out with it, that's fine with me.
Amen.
What the Lord showed me, you're never going to get that out of my heart because it come by fasting and prayer.
Amen.
I asked the Lord one time about something I fasted and I'm not praying. 30 days. I thought I was going to die. My body jerked.
Bless you.
And I said, Lord, kill me or show me the truth. Now you try to take that away from me.
Yeah.
It ain't going to happen.
Right.
But I worship with anybody. I've worshiped with them that brought out the snakes, even though I hit the back door. I worshiped with them until they brought out the snakes. My family down south are snake handlers. I don't have that faith. I'll be the first one to say it. I don't have the faith to pick up a snake. I've let them wash my feet. And I've kicked that pan dry. Woo! Glory! You follow the Holy Ghost, however you lead you.
Yeah, that's right. Yep.
I'm getting down there in years and didn't know I was going to say all this. But I say it to tell you, he's going to walk you through. If you keep your eyes on him,
that's right.
No matter what storm you're going through,
amen.
He said, I'll go with you
that's right.
All
that's
the
right.
way. Sometimes he don't calm that storm.
That's right.
Sometimes he calms me.
Yeah.
I listened to that song this morning, but I had a fit.
because I needed him to call me Steve. And you know what he did? He called me.
Yeah.
Is the storm still out there waiting for me when I walk out that door, Vanessa? It is. He called me.
That's right.
He called me.
You'll be with
you. I'm so thankful that he went to the cross for me. And this is the song that's been in my heart all morning.
Bless the Lord.
I'm going to sing it. Had it not
been. Well, Lord.
Just suppose God searched through the heavens and couldn't find one willing to be. The supreme sacrifice was needed. That would buy eternal life for you and me. Had it not been for a place called Mount Calvary.
That's right, you're mine.
Had it not been Lord, I have of you dying for me. But Lord, I'm so thankful that you set me free. And in time, I'll try to show you what you mean to me. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. There's a room up above me. I've a good place to sleep. There's food on my table and shoes on my feet. You gave me your love, Lord, and a fine family. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings.
My hands and praise him for all he's done. I want gonna try my best to please him. Even though I don't deserve to live, my life has just begun, and I can't help but praise the Lord for all he's done. No, I can't help but praise the Lord for all he's done. Try to sing one, get out of the way. When I'm broken from the battle, and I lost another round, Satan whispers to my troubled mind, just lay your armor down. There are those you love and trusted, look around you, dear, all gone. Would be easy to surrender when you're standing all alone. And then I bow my head in sadness as I ponder what to do. I've been in God's army for so long, and I've been a soldier too. And then I hear a voice from heaven saying, pilgrim, it is I. Lift your head and take new courage and turn your eyes toward the sky. And I see a great band of angels camped all around me. And I see the captain rising up the challenge to me. And I know I'm safe from harm when I'm touching Jesus. Oh yes, the battle is his, the victory is mine, and the victory is sweet. And I see a great band of angels camped all around me. And I see the captain rising up to challenge to me. And I know I'm safe from harm when I'm touching Jesus. Oh yes, the battle is his, the victory is mine, and victory is sweet. The battle is his, the victory is mine, and victory is sweet.
Amen. Amen. Lord bless you. All right, anybody else with a song? Brother Gary, you got one?
You good, man?
Good morning, Brother Phil.
Bless your heart.
Bless the Lord.
I'm still practicing, man.
Bless the Lord.
My throat to us.
Bless Jesus.
Bless your old.
Bless your Lord.
This is the Lord's day.
Come on, brother. Let's go. I can't find it.
You can't have a brother without me. Bless your Lord.
Bless your Lord.
While they're singing, I'd ask the church please to continue to pray for Gary's brother. He's still in surgery. I just got a text message. He's been in surgery since 7:30 this morning. They don't expect him to get out till 2. And I assured her that the church would be praying.
And we will have prayer before we leave. Prayer. God answers prayer.
I said you were my shepherd. I said you were my own. And if by chance I stumble, then you would break my fall. But these were merely words I spoke when others were around. I just came to talk
want to say I'm very thankful that God saved me when I was a little boy. You don't forget stuff like that. A lot of people say, look different and act different and stuff. It doesn't mean a thing to him. He still loves me anyhow.
Bless him, Lord.
And I've been coming to church all my life. I may not know a lot of things, but God called me to do stuff like this, like go to YouTube channel and just for rich people. Just to get someone to get them to the cross before it's too late. If we don't get them to the cross first right now, this may be the last opportunity that we do. Because the cross and Jesus is really important in our lives. And I know that our country is trying to take that away from us. They're trying to take the Bible away. They're trying to take our song books away. They're trying to take everything right out of America. He would have put the world in. He would have put the abortion thing and all that stuff. And they said a baby's just a blob. It's not just a blob. It's a life. It's a life. God gave me. He gave me a life. He gave everybody a life. It's not that little girl right there. That's a life right there. They would destroy something like that. That's demonic, that's deceit, that's evil. That's nothing of God, that's Satan right there. He was to destroy all kids. He don't care about anybody. All he cares about is himself.
Come in here.
My Lord paid a ransom. His blood shed for me. My soul was in bondage, and he set me free. Wallow in the valley, the mountaintop he let me see. Said, keep looking up.
Anybody else? prayer before we leave. I don't know if we got the request or not this morning. Really. This time we'll take the quest. Our chairman says, remember the brother, remember the brother. They say, I'd like to remember them travel. Remember them kids in the